publish it to orchestrator.
Then you need to connect to the orchestrator, right, first?
Yeah.
So where you need to update that testing in the services?
Yeah, I will show you that. I need to first.
You can just drag and drop.
Okay.
No, no, no. See, the best way to do it is you will have. There is no drop down option. We should have a drop down.
Yeah, it's there. It's there.
I am unable to see any values. Are you able to see any values?
No, no.
Okay, then you need to add.
Okay, and machine key. Okay.
So we are connecting with the orchestrator, connected with the orchestrator.
And now I want to show you like where we need to add that. So okay. In this, where it is, you can see attender and one, by default it will be zero.
Okay.
We need to add one. So they are currently giving one testing bot.
Okay.
Once we add, then we will be able to see these things like
test cases, test sets, and test executions.
Correct.
Okay.
So, as you know, the all lot of test cases are there.
Okay.
So when we publish it, before make it, we need to make it publishable. So set as publishable, then only we can publish it. Now you can see the it got green.
Color got changed to blue.
Yeah. Sorry, blue.
Okay.
Publish test cases. Mm-hmm. Okay. Next. Orchestrator, next. Publish it. It got published. And now, normally what we do, we need to create a process.
So for a test case, we need to create a process.
Yeah, normally like we need to tag it to an environment, right?
Okay.
What was the test case name?
SME test automations, first one.
Correct. And this is my environment.
Okay.
These are the in values. So now we have published it. We will go to test case section.
Okay.
I already have two test cases over here. Oh, one was this MuleSort which I created. This is our Acme.
Okay.
Once we have added and made a process, it's available over here.
Okay.
From the test section, we'll do. Give a test name, Acme.
So it's like creating a process first, then creating a job and starting a job.
Correct. So over here we created, and this is our
process name.
Now, so we are creating a test set.
Okay.
Okay, we are creating a test. We can add multiple. I'm just adding one. Okay, this is our data-driven test. Okay, and I'm running it. So now from here also we can execute.
Okay.
And from the execution section we can go and execute.
Okay.
Okay, so I will run this.
Uh-huh.
Are you sure you want to execute the selector system? Yes.
So the bot should be configured with testing bot.
Yeah. Right?
Then only this will be executed.
So you can see four test cases got over there.
Okay.
If it's not testing bot now, then we will not be able to publish also.
Okay.
So when we are connecting our robot to our machine, it should be a testing bot first.
So how this will work? So a developer cannot publish these test cases until he connects it to a testing robot?
Correct.
So that shouldn't be the condition, right? this only for a testing person or someone who is having testing license?
Yeah, actually, because they should have a testing robot license. Then only if they are able to publish the test case.
Let's assume that I'm a developer and I'm writing some test cases internally, though my tester does it. So having a developer license, I will not be able to update or publish any test cases in the orchestrator.
No, with that attended or production or studio license, you can't currently. But like it's again a license, right? A robot testing license you need to be there. Then only you can publish it.
Okay.
So it's still running. I don't know what happened there. Okay, so let's see the result of these first.
U logs.
Verification passed, the expression.
Okay. So it says that it is passed. Okay.
Yeah, all four got passed. And we can schedule it from here, normally like we do.
Okay.
Using cron expression and all these things.
Okay.
We can select our test case, test set, which you want to schedule it. So, yeah, so that's pretty much. And once we have the test set and we have connected our orchestrator with our test management, then all this detail could directly go to our test management.
Okay, test executions.
Yeah.
Okay.